قلت حيلتي أنت وسيلتي، أدركني يا رسول الله، أدركني يا رسول الله.
Another question that we have, and this is more Aqeedah based, is someone was asking with regards to Hazr and Nazr. What is Hazr and Nazr? And how important is this concept? What is this concept of Hazr and Nazr? What does it mean?
This concept of Hazr and Nazr is badly misunderstood, unfortunately, by many people. Many people go to the extremes and say it's shirk, and say that whoever says that the Prophet ﷺ is Hazr and Nazr, then he is a mushrik and he is outside the pale of Islam. The Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Hadir and Nadir. And the meaning of that is that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sees our actions as they are presented to him. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Nadir, since he views our actions both good and bad. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has knowledge about our actions, in terms of when we perform our actions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is able to see the actions of his ummah. Mufti Ahmad Yar Khan Al-Na'imi rahmatullah alayh, in his book, which is a very famous book called, in English, called Obliteration of the Falsehood, and it is a book which we would recommend anybody who can speak the English language or read the English language to purchase. It is available, inshallah, in many Islamic bookshops. Obliteration of the Falsehood. This book is called Ja al-Haq in Urdu, and anybody who can read the Urdu language is strongly advised to gain a copy of this book, because it deals with many of these concepts which are badly misunderstood, such as bid'ah, such as shirk, such as recital of the Fatiha, the concept of Ghiyar-i Sharif, and all these concepts also mentioned within that book. He mentioned inside this book that Hadir Nadir does not mean that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is physically present. It means rather that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam views the actions of his ummah whilst he is in the grave. He can go from his grave to other places where he likes spiritually. He prays for us. These are the meanings that have been given of Hadir and Nadir according to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. So just to reiterate, it means that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam views the actions of his ummah whilst he is in his grave. He can go from his grave to other places where he likes spiritually. He prays for us. This is mentioned by who? Mufti Ahmad Yar Khan Al-Na'im rahmatullahi alayhi, the great ulama of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah from Pakistan. It is also mentioned by the Sharih of Sahih Muslim, the commentator of Sahih Muslim, Al-Allama Ghulam Rasul Sa'idi, Hafidhahullah, who is one of the great ulama of Pakistan at this time, one of the muhaddithun, hadith scholars. He mentions similar to the words of Mufti Ahmad Yar Khan, Na'imi Rahmatullah Alayhi, that our belief is not that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is physically present in every place. Right now, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is physically in every place. This is what some people have believed, and then accused Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah of shirk, and saying that the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is part of this creation, in terms of he's intertwined with creation and so forth. And some people have bad misconception of that. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, being able to see our actions, being able to spiritually be in different places, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making dua for us, of all from the concepts of Hadir Nadir. What does Hadir Nadir mean? Hadir in Arabic means to be present, and Nadir means to view or to have a visualization of something. Now, these are mentioned in the Urdu Hadir Nadir, and we have mentioned to you that the meaning of it is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been given the ability to see the actions of his ummah, meaning that he is not physically present in every place. So here it is metaphorically used, Hadir or Nadir. The ulama mentioned the terminology Hadir Nadir, as Prophet Nadir meaning that he does see. Hadir has been applied, meaning present, has been applied metaphorically, meaning normally the one who sees is what? Is present. The witness, it is mentioned inside the book Mufradat of Al-Imam Raghib Al-Asfahani rahmatullahi. In this book, Mufradat is about the ghirib, those difficult words which are inside the Quran. He mentions that the shahid, the one who is shahid, and we're going to come to this in one of the verses of the Quran, the one who is a shahid, is a witness, is the one who is a hadir, who is present and witnessing, who is nadir at the same time. So if we look at this concept, some people find it difficult. They say, how can the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam see everything, and he's passed away and he's in his grave? And na'udhu billah, some of them say, like one of the scholars the so-called scholars of those who accuse Ahlus Sunnah of shirk, Ibn Uthaymeen, in one of his books, he says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is unable to do anything for anyone. He's dead and he's in his grave. Na'udhu billah. These are the type of concepts that are being passed to, unfortunately, the new generation of Muslims in this country, and we need to clarify them. If we look, for example, the verse of the Quran, in it regarding Shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ, that Shaitan, undoubtedly, and the word inna is used for emphasis, undoubtedly he and his tribe see you once you see them not. Meaning, Shaitan is seeing us and we do not see Shaitan. Not only is Shaitan seeing us, his tribe, meaning the other Shayateen that are under him, are seeing us. The Shayateen can see us, we cannot see them. And we know also that the jinn that are around us, and they exist, they can see us, we cannot see them. We know that the angel of death, for example, is hadir, comes present, and is present and visits the home of the believers, and comes to the homes of the believers, and that the angel of death comes to take the soul of the dying person. We also know the two angel scribes, Raqib and Atid. Some of the ulama say that Raqib is, Sayyidina Raqib is one name, and Sayyidina Atid is one name. Some of the ulama say Raqib Atid is one whole name, meaning each one of them is called Raqib and Atid. And they are angel scribes, they are present, and they witness, but we cannot see them. And here we are told that Shaitan, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ, that they see you from where you cannot see them. So how is it difficult for a believer who has iman in his heart and love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how can he prevent the ni'mah of Allah from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would give him this great quality that he would be able to see the actions of his ummah. It is sheer, subhanallah, what kind of iman is it that you accept these qualities for the shaitan, for example, but you will not accept this ability to see the actions of the ummah for Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there are many proofs of this, many proofs in the Quran regarding this as well. If we look at the first verse of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal nabiyyu inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira. And we have mentioned that Imam Raghib al-Asfahani rahmatullah, in his Mufradat, his book of Al-Mufradat, Kitab al-Mufradat, about the gharib of the Quran, those words which are maybe difficult, he mentions that the shahid, the one who is shahid, and the verse mentions, أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. O Prophet, may Allah bless and grant him peace, no doubt we have sent you as a witness, bearer of glad tidings and a warner, a witness. Here, this witnessing which is mentioned, this is the understanding of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah regarding the concept of Hadir and Nadir. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a witness, is a shahid. And Imam Raghib al-Asfahani rahmatullah alayhi says that the meaning of shahid in the Arabic language is that someone witnesses while being Hadir, while being present. So it is for this reason that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he is shahid, that metaphorically Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah have said he is Hadir. Meaning that normally the one who is shahid is present. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we do not say he is present in every single space within the universe. No. We say yes, Allah has given him the ability to leave the vicinity of his grave spiritually and go to places. And people have seen Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The ulama have seen Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a waking state. It is an undeniable fact that is mentioned in the books of the narrations of the ulama, is mentioned in the lives of the ulama and the hayat of the ulama. This is why Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is hadir and nadir.
MashaAllah, jazakum Allah. Is this not the same for the souls of the believers, that they too are able and free to roam the world? And
this is mentioned surprisingly by who? Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. Now I mention Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah's name here, and I do not take him as a reference, meaning the reason why I'm mentioning his name, I want to make it clear that we are not taking him as a reference inside the Sharia. He is a student of Ibn Taymiyyah. Regarding Ibn Taymiyyah, we have been told by the ulama of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah that he is a person who was dal, misguided, and mudil, misguiding. And similarly, his student Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. The reason why I'm mentioning him here is that maybe someone out there who takes these people as a reference might wake up to the reality that Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah himself admits to the the traveling of the arwah, mm-hmm. not of the anbiya. Yes, of the anbiya, he admits it, even lesser than the anbiya, the average human Muslim, the average Muslim. He permits and says in his book that the souls of the believers in general travel and leave the vicinity of their graves. This is mentioned in Kitab al-Ruh. Kitab al-Ruh, if anybody wants to know, that I don't think has been translated into English. It's in Arabic. But if anybody wants to know the truth regarding this, then they need to go and have a look in that book, Kitab al-Ruh of Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyah. And he's known for his strong, hard stance against Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah in many concepts. Yet in this concept of the soul of the believer moving around, he permits it even for one far less than the Anbiya.
SubhanAllah. Jazakumullah for that. The other question that in continuation with that is with regards to this concept of Hazir Nazir. Generally, people translate it as being omnipresence, and then they say that this is an attribute which is specific for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How could you attribute that to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
First of all, Hazir and Nazir are two words. The question is, are these two words used in the Quran, or have they been used by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to describe Allah anywhere within the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We find the answer is no. The word Hadir, for example, first of all, cannot be used for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists without a place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in no need of time, no need of place. To say somebody is Hadir means physically present. We do not say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a jism, a body, nor that he is made up of parts. Na'udhu billah. So we cannot use the word, categorically cannot use the word Hadir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all, at all. Now, the concept of nadir, the word nadir is not used for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are told in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, innahu huwa sami'ul basir, that Allah is sami', that Allah sees everything, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness to everything in creation, meaning nothing escapes him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the word nadir itself is never used for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are told within the books of Aqaid, we cannot give a name to an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except that which has come through the Quran or the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We do not find any evidence within the Quran or the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for using the word hadir or nadir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we cannot say that it is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a misconception in those minds who haven't understood the basic understanding of aqidah, which is that the attributes of Allah are all tawqifi, meaning we cannot give a name to the attribute of Allah to an attribute of Allah without it, an evidence being present.
That's why I'm asking again. One of the things that people obviously generally accuse the Ahl Sunnah with regards to this concept of Hazir Nazir is that you give the same attribute to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as you give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You've clarified that. It's worth clarifying how this attribute of Hazir Nazir, is it something from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or is it something that is given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
Even before that, if we look in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, "Inna Allah bin Nasi la Ra'ufur Rahim."
Subhanallah.
"Inna Allah bin Nasi la Ra'ufur Rahim." This is one example, just one example. Allah is Ra'uf and He's Rahim, compassionate and merciful. In another verse of the Quran, we are told, لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَأُوفُ رَحِيمٌ. The same word is used. Allah is لَرَأُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is رَأُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. So رَأُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. So here, those who accuse Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah of shirk, we have a question to them. That in the Quran, Allah uses the same word, Ra'uf Rahim, to describe himself. He uses the same word to describe his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ra'uf Rahim. So what is happening here? In the minds of many people out there now who hold this concept that if you use a similar word that is used for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another verse of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Innahu huwa sami'ul basir. Yet it is mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given us sam' and basar. He has given us sam' and basar, given us sight and hearing. But here we need to know that the only similarity here is in word, in the word form. The meaning is different totally. Where are the attributes of Allah? Where are the attributes of human beings? We hear with what? Eardrum and ear sound and so waves. Forth. We cannot even imagine what it's meant by the sam', the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means that nothing in creation escapes him. But it's detail, no one knows. No one knows the detail of that, because that is a sifa, an attribute of the Creator. That is one of the divine attributes. Again, Ra'uf Rahim, the Prophet ﷺ is compassionate and merciful. Compassion is a feeling within the heart of a human being. And the Prophet ﷺ is the best of all creation, best of human beings. So it is a feeling in the heart of the Prophet ﷺ, and the greatest, in the greatest of hearts. And with Allah, na'udhu billah, we cannot give the same meaning. So the meaning differs straight away. Regarding Hadir and Nadir, that the people say, if you could reiterate the question.
The question was that people say that this is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but why have you given it to the Prophet? So you've answered that question. But the important aspect of this question was that this is not something from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from his own possession, but rather it is something which is given to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
In Surah Ali Imran, Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salam says, "Uhyi al-mawta," that I give life to the death. I give life to the dead. "Uhyi al-mawta," who gives life to the dead? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. "Yuhyi wa yumit," Allah is muhyi and He is mumit, gives life and gives death. Yet in Surah Ali Imran, we are told that Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salam said to the people that "Uhyi al-mawta," I give life to the dead. Shirk. Na'udhu billah, this is the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us the story of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam says, "Bi'idhnillah," by the idhn, by the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give life to the dead by the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when somebody who is a Muslim, who is a believer, and nothing, there is nothing to show that he's except a believer, when he says the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is hadir or nadir, and he says the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam witnesses, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is able, his ruh, his soul is able to come out of his grave, then we should have husn adhan. That is a believer in the oneness of Allah, a person who knows tawheed and knows that that quality has been given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by Allah, and that nothing in creation acts independently from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the prophets are alive in their graves.
Again, that is a question that inshallah we can put forward to yourself with regards to prophets being alive in their graves.
The concept of the prophets being alive in their graves is something that each and every Muslim really should know. Regarding this, Sayyiduna al-Imam Suyuti rahmatullah alayhi, and I'll quote what he says. قال السيوطي رحمة الله عليه في ملقات السعود تواترت بحياة الأنبياء في قبورهم. That the rewires, the narrations that have reached us from ahadith about the lives of the Anbiya in their graves are of the level of mass narration, the highest form of narration in hadith. He says, تواترت بحياة الأنبياء في قبورهم الأخبار. وقال الحافظ السيوطي رحمة الله عليه في أنباء الأذكياء بحياة الأنبياء. Is one of his great books about the lives of the Anbiya. He says, حَيَاتُ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فِي قَبْرِهِ وَهُوَ وَصَائِرُ الْأَنْبِيَا مَعْلُومَةٌ عِنْدَنَا عِلْمًا قَطْعِيًا.
SubhanAllah.
That the knowledge of the Anbiya alive in their graves is a knowledge which we know definitively. It's قَطْعِي knowledge, definite knowledge, because of the mass narration. لِمَا قَامَ عِنْدَنَا مِنَ الْأَدِلَّةِ فِي ذَلِكَ. Due to the evidences that have been established regarding it. وَتَوَاتَرَتْ بِهَا الْأَخْبَارُ الدَّالَّةُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. And the rewires which have reached us, the evidences, have reached the level of mass narration regarding that. He said, وَقَدْ أَلَّفَ الْإِمَامُ الْبَيْحَقِيُّ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ, the great muhaddith, الْإِمَامُ الْبَيْحَقِيُّ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ, جُزْءًا فِي حَيَاةِ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ عَلَيْهِمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ فِي قُبُورِهِمْ. That Imam al-Bayhaqi رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ, before Imam Suyuti رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ, has already written a book regarding the lives of the Anbiya and their graves. One of the narrations that the ulama based this upon is the narration of Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الأنبياء أحياء في قبورهم يصلون. That the Anbiya are alive in their graves and they pray. The hadith is sahih. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahmatullah in his commentary on al-Bukhari says the hadith is sahih, is narrated in the Musnad of Imam Bazzar. And also a second hadith is the hadith also in the sahih, which is sahih, which is authentic, narrated by Al-Bazzar. Al-Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حياتي خير لكم تحدثون ويحدث لكم ووفاتي خير لكم تعرضوا علي أعمالكم فما كان من حسن حمدت الله عليه وما كان من سيء استغفرت الله لكم. He said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, my life is a great good for you. You will relate about me and it will be related to you. My death is a great good for you. Your actions will be presented to me in my grave, and if I see goodness, I will praise Allah, and if I see other than that, I will ask forgiveness of him for you. Imam Suyuti rahmatullah alayhi mentioned this hadith. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Haythami rahmatullah alayhi in Majma' al-Zawaid mentioned this hadith and said it is from Al-Bazzar and that its relators are all men of sahih hadith. It was also mentioned by Al-Hafidh al-Iraqi rahmatullah alayhi. He said his chain is good, it's isnaduhu jayyid, meaning it is a hadith which is sahih. So this is the lives of the Anbiya in their graves. And it is a sad fact that we live in a time where people are denying this, despite that the early ulama have mentioned that it is something which is definitive, the lives of the Anbiya.